In the first section, we took care of the installation of the necessary software for this course and got a quick look at Unity's interface. In this section, you will learn about game objects, prefabs, and assets. So let's begin with the game objects and components. Everything that you can see in the scene view or in the hierarchy is a game object. Game objects do not have to be visible in the game but still can have a function. You should see two game objects in the hierarchy, main camera and directional light. Neither of them will be visible, but as you can tell from the names, one of them will serve as a camera and the other as a light source. Click on any of them and you will see its properties, or rather components, in the inspector window. Each of these components provides certain functionality. For example, on the directional light object, you will see a light component. Similarly, on the main camera, you should see a camera component. You can add or remove components or edit them from the inspector window. Let's try it out on an example. First, create an empty game object using the Create menu in the Hierarchy window, or just right-click in the Hierarchy window and click on Create Empty. This is the most basic game object. You can change the name of an object by selecting it in the hierarchy and clicking on it once more, or by pressing the F2 button on your keyboard. As you can see, it has a transform component. As I mentioned in the previous video, transform holds the information about the position, rotation, and the scale of an object. Since each game object needs to know where it is in the 3D space, it has to have a transform component. Notice that you still can change the position, scale, and rotation of this object. But since it is not visible, we won't see any change besides the position in the scene view. So let's make it visible by adding Mesh Renderer and Mesh Filter components. Mesh is basically a 3D model, and the Mesh Filter component will store the reference to a 3D model. Renderer component will tell Unity to draw the model specified in the Mesh Filter component. Click Add Component button and you will see a drop-down menu with different categories. You can search for a component by directly writing its name in the search field or by navigating in the menu manually. Since we know what components we want, let's just search for them. First, search for the Mesh Filter component and click on it to add. Then click on the circle next to the mesh field. It is a picking tool. It will automatically open a new window, listing all available objects you can set to this field. You can choose from the current scene or the assets. Since we don't have any meshes in the scene, choose the Assets tab and select a cube mesh. We added the mesh, but still cannot see it in the scene view. It is because we don't have the Mesh Renderer component yet. Add it in the same way you just added the mesh filter. And there is your cube. If you don't see it in the scene view, then probably it means that you are not looking at it. Make sure that the cube is selected in the hierarchy. Move the mouse to the scene view and press F button on your keyboard. This way you can focus on an object. Note that you can do this the other way around as well. Select an object from the scene view, move the mouse to the hierarchy and press F. The selected object will be highlighted. This will become very useful when you will have more complex scenes. Now you definitely should be able to see it. The only problem is its color. This particular color indicates that there is something wrong with the shader of the object. In our case, the problem is that we haven't set any yet. We'll talk about shaders and materials in later videos. For now, click on this arrow over here and it will expand the material list. Again, don't worry about the exact meaning of it. I will explain it in more details in the following videos. If the size is 0, make it 1 and element 0 should pop up. Set the material just like we did with the mesh. Choose the default diffuse material and the cube should turn to gray. And finally, we made our very first 3D cube in Unity. If you paid attention to the Create menu before, then you probably have noticed submenus like 3D object, 2D object, and so on. In those menus, you can find some more preset game objects. For example, if you choose 3D and click on the cube, then Unity will create a new cube, just like ours. The only difference is that it has one more component, Box Collider. Colliders define the physical boundaries of an object. We will go in more details in the final video of this section. The next very important thing I would like to talk about is the parenting of the objects. To better demonstrate what it means, select one of the cubes you just created, reset its position and rotation to zero. You can do it manually or by clicking on this cog icon and selecting the reset option. It resets all of the component's variables to default values. Focus on a cube and create a sphere. Move the sphere next to the cube, then in the hierarchy window, drag the sphere on the cube. Notice how in the hierarchy window, the sphere has a slight offset. It means that it is a child of the cube. Now it will move, rotate, and scale relative to its parent. Just select the cube, move it around, and you will see that the sphere is following it. Also, it means that the values of the sphere do not change. The reason is, as I mentioned before, these values are relative to the parent of an object. There is one last useful tip I will mention in this video. See these two buttons at the top of the editor window? Right now, they should be set to local and pivot. If you hover the mouse over them, their tooltips will appear. Toggle tool handle position and toggle tool handle rotation. When the rotation is set to local, you will see the axis indicator of the object is in its local space. Meaning, you will see these indicators pointing in the object's respective axis, not global ones. Click on it to toggle, and you will see that it has changed to global, and the axis indicator points in the same direction as the global axis. Now select the parent cube object, toggle the pivot button, and you will see that the axis indicator moves in between the cube and the sphere. Right now, it is at the center of mass of the object and its children. All of these settings can be useful in different situations, so just keep them in mind. For now, I will leave them as pivot and global. Finally, to remove a component, click on the cog icon and click on the remove component option. And that is it for this video. So far you have learned how to create game objects, how to add, remove, and manipulate components, and what parenting means in Unity's context.